four bars, he said. But
did I?
You can cue me in if you want. Yeah.
Welcome to our 2022 concert. Today's concert is in support of PWRDF's Hurricane Fiona Relief Fund. If you're watching online, so great that you're here. The link is in the description. If you're here, they do have a machine at the back if you feel so inclined as to donate. Every cent of what you give tonight goes to Hurricane Fiona. None of it comes to us. So please give if you can. We're really happy that you're here, that you're back, that we're comfortable and you can sing. This is all kind of new relative to the last 2 years. So it's so great. We're also happy to have Will Postma here, the executive director of PWRDF, who's gonna speak to us later. And we also have another special guest, Peter Mentis, who is the FaithWorks campaign manager. We're very glad that you're here as well. So great that you could join us in person. Before we welcome Melinda and John, who you've already heard sing back, Denise is up to honor the Indigenous community with the land acknowledgement.
Today we honor and acknowledge that this land and locality is the historical traditional lands of the Indigenous peoples of what we call Turtle Island and what is commonly called North America. We acknowledge the leadership of Indigenous elders who continue to teach us about what it means to live in a balanced and good way with all creation. May our time together be blessed as we give respect to the first peoples of this land and seek to live in right relationship with ourselves, Creator, and one another. We pray that the Spirit will lead us into all truth, into repentance for the wrongs of the past, and into true reconciliation with our Indigenous brothers and sisters, that we may be partners in healing and peace to the glory and thanksgiving of God, our Creator.
Thank you, Denise. And now we're going to have Melinda come back up to sing her first solo. We're so thrilled Melinda's here. She's been in the theater world for a while now. She's done so many amazing productions at Mirvish and Aquarius. And so we're just really grateful that she's here to sing for us.
Mm-hmm.
the bells that'll tingle all your troubles away. Everybody's waiting for the man with the bag. Christmas is here again. He's got a sleigh full, it's not gonna stay full. He's got stuff to drop at every step of the way. Everybody's waiting for the man with the bag. Christmas is here again. He'll be here with the answer to the prayers that you've made through the year. You'll get yours if you've got everything you should. Extra special good, he'll make this December the one you'll remember, the best and the merriest you ever did have. You'll remember the best and the merriest you ever did have. Everybody's waiting. We're all congregating, waiting for the man with the bag.
Okay, we're gonna switch it up a little bit now. We're gonna bring the choir up. The choir has not been singing until a couple of months ago, and they're back. And so they're really excited to present something for us here. It's been a long time since they've been able to sing together. So we picked Carol of the Bells. It's super traditional at this time of year. And we have Tim with his vibraphones, which is gonna be the closest to bells. Maybe a little nicer than bells, I would say. So it's kind of a nice opportunity for us to bring everything together. It's not just the choir, it's also the band, and it's, you know, the joy again of being with each other. So the choir is going to come up and present Carol of the Bells for us. Thank you, and welcome back. John's going to come back. He's going to sing another traditional one, though it's going to sound a slightly different. John's been singing jazz for a while, and it's in his family. It's come down. So why don't you introduce yourself a little bit, John, so people can get to know you.
Hi, everybody. My name is John, like Myron was saying. I'm a graduate from the Humber Jazz Program, but I have been singing in the Anglican Church and in the church ever since I was a little boy. So it's really great to be here, to be singing for you folks and be singing in this nice room. I've worked with big bands. I've run my own jazz ensemble. I've seen Melinda on the show that she did at Mervish, so it's, you know, a little bit stressful being here with some great talent, and everybody else also really great. So, this is What Child Is This?
What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping? What angels greet with anthems sweet while shepherds watch is such mean estate where ox and ass are feeding. Good Christians fear for sinners here. The silent word is pleading. This is Christ the King, whom shepherds guard and angels sing.
So now we switch it up again, and you'll probably get that theme as we go along. It keeps jumping all over the place. Every year I ask Evan to play a solo, and every year he picks an artist that I love. So last year he picked Stevie. This year he picked my mom's favorite, Harry Belafonte. We listen to him all the time at home, and Evan tells me it was the same at his place. So I'm thrilled that we got to squeeze him into the concert. And so here's Evan playing The Baby Boy by Harry Belafonte. Thank you.
I rose to join the glorious morn, whose calm and splendor would adorn the Virgin Mother's infant born, the blessed dawn of Christmas Day. The hearts of sinners reconciled amid the ancient moral mild, exalt the birth of Mary's child, the blessed dawn of Christmas Day. I pray one day
So the next two songs are not so obvious for a Christmas program. Well, maybe the first one. It's called Christmas Lullaby. Both of them are by a composer named Jason Robert Brown. So Melinda is from the musical theater world, and anybody in musical theater knows Jason Robert Brown. He was one of the first musicals I worked on. So they're kind of juxtaposed against each other. They're like a little mini set for Melinda and me. The first one is a woman singing about her having a child, which it's called Christmas Lullaby, I assume, because of the simile to Mary. The second one's not a Christmas song. It's kind of like a love song, but it's a song about all the materiality and stuff that she's looking for and maybe missing all the things along the way. So we jam these two together because one of them's sort of the beginning, right? It's having a baby, having a family, and one of them's maybe a little later looking back on everything that's happened over the Christmases gone by. Again, maybe like last year. This all works in my head. I don't know if it translates to anybody else. But that doesn't matter because I'm really happy to play it with Melinda.
Future of the world and
And I will be like Mother Mary with a blessing in my soul.
Give you cars and a townhouse in turn. and I got my yacht. And the years went by, and it never changed, and it never grew, and I never dreamed. And I woke one day, and I looked around, and I thought, my God, I'll never have the moon. So
now we get to mix it up again. We're going to pick up the tempo a little bit. So John and Melinda are going to come up and...
Something completely different?
Yeah, and now for something completely different.
The ivy green, the prettiest picture you've ever seen. It's Christmas in Killarney with all of the folks at home. It's nice to know to kiss your beau while cuddling under the mistletoe. And Santa Claus, you know, of course, is one of the boys from home. The door is always open, the neighbors pay a call. And Father Steve, before he's gone, will bless the house and all. And it feels to click your heels and join in the fun of the jigs and reels. It's Christmas in Killarney with all of the folks at home. It's holly green, the ivy green, the prettiest picture you've ever seen. It's Christmas in Killarney with all of the folks at home. It's nice to know to kiss your beau and cuddling under the mistletoe. It's Christmas in Killarney with all of the folks from home. We'll decorate the Christmas tree when all the family's around. The roaring fire will raise a glass of cheer. And glad it feels to click your heels and join in the fun of the jigs and reels. It's Christmas in Killarney with all of the folks at home. Listen to the jingle bells everywhere, everywhere we go. It's time to feel to click your heels and join in the fun of the jigs and reels. It's Christmas in Killarney with all of the folks at home. The holly green, the ivy green, the prettiest picture you've ever seen. I'm handing you the likes you've never known. It's Christmas in Killarney for all of the folks at home.
Thank you. So that's about the halfway point. So we should probably stop and have Will Postma come up. He's going to tell us about why we're here and what we're giving to, and share a little bit of information about what we're trying to do this all for during the Christmas season. So Will, please come up. Thank you for joining us, and thank you for being here.
Well, thanks so very much for the invitation to be here this afternoon, this fourth Sunday of Advent. Thank you, Reverend Canon Stephen, Denise, Myron. Thank you for such lovely music. What a gift. What special voices and instruments. So big thank you to John, Melinda, Jennifer, Myron, is it Myron? Myron and Tim and Evan, just making this day so much more special. Just want to say thanks also to Peter Mentis. Peter and I have talked by email, but we've never seen each other. Here we are, somewhat post-COVID. Thank you, Peter, because Faith Works, where Peter works, just supports so many good ministries in the Diocese of Toronto and beyond as well, and that includes PWRDF. So very glad to be part of Faith Works. You know, a year ago, Holy Trinity, the Church of Holy Trinity, raised funds for the work of Pimatisowan Nipi, Cree for Living Waters. It was an encouraging gift that contributed to further work in retrofitting homes in Pekangikum First Nation. I was able to visit there this past summer, along with others of the Anglican Church of Canada, including a priest and volunteer from another First Nation, Bearskin Lake, also in Northern Ontario. Today, more and more people have access to running water in their homes, rather than having to go outside to fill jugs from water points. And more homes have indoor plumbing rather than an outhouse. So hard for all of us, so hard for the elderly especially, and so hard in winter months. This year, Pimatisowan Nipi Living Waters is collaborating further with Kingfisher First Nation in Northern Ontario in support of a purchase of a new water distribution truck for their community. So a big thank you to the Church of Holy Trinity for supporting PWRDF and Pimatisowan Nipi Living Waters. And thank you for supporting a response in this concert, in this season, to Hurricane Fiona. You know, an Anglican priest in Charlottetown shared with me that Hurricane Fiona was so much more damaging than Hurricane Dorian, that started in the Caribbean, moved itself northwards to the Maritimes, to Atlantic Canada. And this particular storm, Fiona, was kind of like, he said, Dorian on steroids. It was 5 to 8 times more impactful in terms of the damage that it had done, in terms of outages, power outages, just in terms of money that was lost because of this storm. You know, the day after the storm, PWRDF's diocesan representative, our volunteer in Nova Scotia in Prince Edward Island, he shared the following. He said, now this was an unprecedented storm event. It was very violent. It was very scary. Fiona arrived about 10 p.m. on Friday night and left about midday on Saturday. The destruction, he said at the time, is very severe. Buildings have been moved off of foundations, roofs ripped off buildings, cottages are picked up and thrown into the sea, and there was so much damage to crops. Our volunteer in Western Newfoundland, where the heavily impacted community of Port-au-Basque is located, she said that as many as 88 persons had lost their homes because of the storm, because of the hurricane. And although some found short-term housing, sometimes with family, they are in need of longer-term solutions. Some clergy are saving funds for future needs, such as furnishing a house or an apartment when long-term housing becomes available for the 25 or so families that still do not have accommodations that they can go to. You know, a priest in Cape Breton, he used the word catastrophe when he spoke with us. He said there's a local state of emergency there. The military have been called to help. People have lost their homes, and roads and other infrastructure have been severely damaged. It's also an economically disadvantaged area with a large number of seniors. And around the world, here in Canada, when hurricanes hit or when other disasters, it's often those who are already very vulnerable who are most impacted. And such was the case in Cape Breton and in other areas of Atlantic Canada. There is an Indigenous Mi'kmaq community worker in southeast New Brunswick, where Pointe du Chien is located, so also very much impacted by Hurricane Fiona. And she said that the hurricane of September 24 will be remembered for a very, very long time. Many people close to the coast, they left their home and they moved inland as the storm approached. There were storm surges, floodings, high winds that left behind damages that are still felt today. There were flooded basements, damage to properties, thawed food that needed to be thrown, and massive trees had fallen. Many people, she said, have had to have their drinking water tested, and it has been found to be unsuitable because of the well water quality being so impacted by the storm. Many lower income people did not have enough insurance. An even greater need that she said, this is the indigenous Mi'kmaq woman who was writing, an even greater need would be to have a proper community plan for the next storm. And with the reality of climate change, this area will continue to be at risk for storm surges and flooding. Something as simple as community-provided generators, she said, could make a big, big difference. The community will move forward, but we need to stand with them, she said, in this time of need. So PWRDF is responding to Hurricane Fiona, as we have done last year when fires and floods caused so much damage in central British Columbia, and when wildfires ripped through Fort McMurray in 2016, or as we have responded this year as well to flooding in Pakistan, which has claimed thousands of lives, and where we are working with Church World Service and the Church of Pakistan, an Anglican church in Pakistan, to provide food, clean water, health care, and temporary accommodations. We are continuing to listen to church and community members in Atlantic Canada. I'm in regular conversation with the diocesan office, with the bishop, Sandra Fife. We know that there were important short-term supports from government funds, from the Red Cross, and from others, supports that we do not want to duplicate, but build on while affected communities go forward. So in partnership with the affected diocese, we're listening to community requests for generators, for equipping emergency warming stations, for help in planning and preparedness, for psychosocial or pastoral counseling that may be needed, and for community gatherings, for community meals, for community workshops. One community is requesting support for a propane generator to serve as the community comfort station, working closely with the county, the municipality, to access also a small provincial grant. And she was saying the support from PWRDF, our support, will enable a provincial grant to also allow them to do a bigger, a better job in equipping community comfort stations and enough generators for what could be and what almost certainly would be next storms. It's precisely giving like this that for PWRDF, and when combined with other revenue sources from provincial governments, from municipalities, that our support and your support, our support together, can go so much further. It's such an important response in Canada to climate risk. PWRDF's vision is for a world that is truly just, healthy, and at peace. And in this season, just how important those words are: justice, peace, and health. And that includes countries where we work around the world with partners: Yemen, South Sudan, Ukraine, Pakistan, but also here in Canada. I just want to thank you for your prayers, for gifts that will support this important response. Hurricane Fiona did impact communities in such important ways, and we want to be there to be supportive to the diocese, to the parishes, and to the communities. We're really grateful. We're just grateful for this wonderful concert. We're grateful for choosing Hurricane Fiona and our response to Hurricane Fiona as a fundraiser at this time of the year. So a big thank you once again, and I'm looking forward to the rest of the concert, as I'm sure you are as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Will. If you want to stretch your legs, it's not a bad time to stand up because you're supposed to sing again. So the choir is going to come up and lead us in another traditional carol. Everybody gets to stretch their legs a little bit. Stand up from the pews. And as a reminder, there is a machine at the back if anybody who is here does want to donate to the cause. Michael said to make sure I mention it at least 7 times. That's 2. That's 2 so far.
Hark! The herald angels sing, glory to God.
Thank you. Okay, so we enter into another little mini set of music. So the first one is classical, so I'm going to let Jen speak about that in a second. The second one is a little bit of Canadiana, but it's not the happiest Christmas song you're ever going to sing. And I always think in a Christmas concert, it's important to acknowledge both ends of that, right? There's all the joy that comes with Christmas, and there's sometimes maybe a bit of sorrow that comes at that time of year as well. And then after we play those two, and after you've had a good chance to wrestle with all those emotions, we'll lighten the mood a lot and play a little pop tune that hopefully reminds us that we do have somebody out there. Find that somebody that you can lean on. But the first song is a classical piece, and I'm going to let Jen intro that one.
This is Peace for Violin and Piano, written by the African-American composer Jesse Montgomery. She wrote this piece a month, she said, after the great sadness of the first quarantine orders due to COVID-19. She wrote it in April 2020. Facing the shock felt by the whole globe, as well as personal crisis, I find myself struggling to define what actually brings me joy. And I'm at a stage of making peace with sadness, as it comes and goes like any other emotion. I'm learning to observe sadness for the first time, not as a negative emotion, but as a necessary dynamic to the human experience. I don't want to bring everybody down. When we think peace, I first came across this this work by its title, Peace, and I thought, oh, that'll be great for Christmas. And then I read what it was about, and I thought, you know, peace, comfort, joy, and joy's silent sister sadness that we don't bring to the Christmas dinner table, but I find that sometimes she needs a seat, and she's there in our thoughts with our loved ones who can't be with us, and I hope that this beautiful, beautiful work by Jesse Montgomery helps to bring you peace.
Thank you.
tried hard to help me, put me at ease. He loved me so naughty, made me weak in the knees. Oh, I wish I had a river I could skate away on. Too hard to handle, I'm selfish and I'm sad.
If you ever find yourself lost in the dark and you can't see, I'll be the light to guide you. Find out what you're made of when you call to help your friend in need. You can count on me, like 1, 2, 3, I'll be. And I know when I need you, I can count on you. Like 4, 3, 2, you'll be there. 'Cause that's what friends are supposed to do, oh yeah. Just can't fall asleep, I'll sing a song beside you. And if you forget how much you really mean to me, every day I will remind you. I'll find out what you're made of. Count on me, like 1, 2, 3, I'll be there. And I know when I need you, I can count on you, like 4, 3, 2, and I'll be there. 'Cause that's what friends are supposed to do, oh yeah.
It's always important if you're going to sing that you bring a cheering section. Always really important.
Showing off how high you can sing? I can't sing that high. Nice. Oh my goodness.
We're going to go back to the standards. Nat King Cole was a regular in our place. Nat King Cole is like the Christmas icon, right? He sings all the Christmas tunes. So John's going to bring his jazz voice to a Nat King Cole classic.
It's not Christmas, but it's Christmas enough, I think. It's good theming.
Tim was gracious enough to bring his vibes again. We heard them during Carol of the Bells. And there's some of those tunes that you have to get every Christmas. And I know I made the same joke last year, so hopefully only half the people from last year are watching. But Christmas Time Is Here is one of those tunes. You need to have it at Christmas. So Tim's going to play that for us. It's a classic from the 60s. Vince Guaraldi's music is part of the Christmas canon. So Tim's going to grace us with a vibe solo of Christmas Time Is Here. Blows me away every time. Thanks, Tim. That was great.
Someday at Christmas, men won't be boys, playing with bombs like kids play with toys. One warm December, our hearts will see a world where we are free. Someday at Christmas, there'll be no wars, when we have learned what Christmas is for. When we have found what life's really worth, there'll be peace on earth. Someday all our dreams will come to be. Someday in a world where we are free. Maybe not in time for you and for me, but someday at Christmas time. Someday at Christmas there'll be no tears, with no hungry children and no empty hand. One happy morning people will share a world where people care. Someday fears, one shining day, no one prayer away, a world from here today. Someday all our dreams will come to be, someday in a world where we are free. Maybe not in time for you and me, but someday at Christmas time.
We're in the home stretch, so these are the home songs. You got two in a row. One of them is not actually in there, which is my fault. Nicole sends me the bulletin to review, and I swear I do review it, but I almost always miss at least two things. So one of the things I missed is a song. So we have, first we'll have John sing I'll Be Home for Christmas, and then we'll have John and Melinda duet for Please Come Home for Christmas. So a couple of different tunes, but we're in the home stretch here, so we're going to focus on home for a bit.
I'm dreaming tonight of a place I love even more than I usually do. And although I know it's a long road back, I promise you Eve will find me. bells will be ringing the sad, sad news. Oh, what a Christmas to have the blues. Oh, my baby's gone, I have no friends to wish me greetings. Oh, once again.
The next song is not a Christmas song. My first music director was You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown. So that's a slight tie-in since we did Christmas Time is Here. It's a similar theme. It's called Happiness, and it's basically about, it's a bunch of little kids, the Charlie Brown kids, saying all the things they're happy for. And they're the things you would expect kids to say. And I find as I listen to the song, it's the same stuff that makes me happy. I don't know, we'll go around the room real quick. Melinda, happiness at the Christmas season. What makes you happy?
Ice cream.
John?
I think when you get on the train, the train's right there at the right time.
Right.
Always makes me feel good.
Right. You get to be on time. Jen?
Watching you play with our kids.
I told you to say that. She works for me for one night. Yeah, it's all the same stuff. So this song is kind of a medley of the closing song from You're a Good Man, Charlie Brown, the musical, which was reworked a bunch of years ago, and it's called Happiness. Thank you.
Happiness is finding a pencil, pizza with sausage telling the time. Happiness is learning to whistle, tying your shoes for the very first time.
Happiness is playing a drum to your own school band. And happiness is walking hand in hand.
Happiness is two kinds of ice cream. Climbing a tree.
Happiness is five different crayons.
Catching a firefly, setting it free. Happiness is being alone every now and then.
And happiness is coming home again.
Happiness is anyone and anything at all that's loved by you.
Happiness is having a family, sharing a sandwich, getting along.
When you get to program the concert, you get a little choice. That one's actually for my kids because I like listening and dancing to that one at home. So I saw some bouncing heads on the side there, so I'm already won the medal if it's all right. Before we go to our last song, I think we'd be remiss if we didn't take 1 second to say thank you. So I'm really, really grateful, especially with how things are so crazy and changing for 2-3 years now, that people give of their time. And it takes a lot of time to throw this together and a lot of effort. So I really want to pause now to thank Tim, Evan, John, Melinda, and Jen for coming here and performing with me. It's always fun to play with people who are so talented and so warm. So thank you very much for all of your time and effort. I really appreciate it. Again, this is all in support of relief for Hurricane Fiona. So if you can, please give and give generously. The link is in the YouTube video description. There's machines at the back. If you need any more information, please come and find any one of us from the church, Stephen, myself, Denise, Nicole, and we can help you. And I think we're at a church concert, so I think it's important that we have Stephen come up as well. So, Father Stephen, if you could come up and grace us with a blessing.
Well, while we're saying thank you, a huge thank you and round of applause for our own Myron de Souza. Wow. Woo! And it, what fabulous talent. So thank you, thank you. And to Will and Peter for, you know, single-handedly how much good we can do. We can do a bit, but when we come together and do good, we can do great things. And my nana used to say, charity begins at home. So we do a lot of work with refugees, and over the years we've helped people from the Sudan and Syria and now Afghanistan, and yet our own Canadian folk down east, we need to care for them. So I already know you're generous, and Christmas is a time for giving, so thank you for helping us as all the money goes to Hurricane Fiona. I have a rumor that we are open Christmas Eve and Christmas Day. So if you're in the Christmas mood and you really want to keep the Christmas spirit going, we're having Christmas Eve services 7 o'clock, 11 o'clock, and then Christmas Day at 10:30, and we would love to see you again. Finally, the great thing about, well, not the great thing, but one of the nicer things about this cloud of a pandemic endemic has been that once you're online, you can keep on sharing this. So these fabulous talents, you can listen to them again. You can send them to a friend. You can share the good news of this season. So to those of you who are with us online, we are so glad that you can be with us through the internet. Please subscribe to our Holy Trinity YouTube channel. And why not take this wonderful concert, share it on your socials so that people can hear these wonderful talents and also make a difference to Hurricane Fiona. And with that, let us have a short prayer. Let us pray. Loving and gracious God, you show us the tenderness of your love in your newborn son. Like Mary, may we always be attentive to your spirit and ready to say yes to your will, so that Jesus may be born anew in us. Like Joseph, may we always be aware of your presence in our lives and the needs of others. Like the shepherds, may we be alert and looking forward in joyful anticipation of what is to come. Like the kind innkeeper, may we be awake to serve you and others when the opportunities present themselves. We ask you to prepare us to welcome Jesus into our hearts, so like the angels who announced his birth, we too may greet his coming. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and grant you peace.
Thank you, Stephen. And I made a mistake, and I did not thank the choir, who are the other artists that came and spent all that effort and all that time. So thank you to the choir for all that hard work. And I apologize. And we end with a little Canadiana. So if you know it, bop along, sing along, whatever you'd like. Thanks for coming. 1, 2, 3, 4.
God rest ye merry gentlemen, let nothing you dismay. Remember Christ our Savior was born upon this day to save us all from Satan's power when we had gone astray. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy. From God our Heavenly Father this blessed angel came, and unto certain shepherds brought tidings of the same, how that in Bethlehem was born the Son of God by name. Oh, good tidings of comfort and joy, comfort and joy. Oh, tidings of comfort and joy.
I think if you're gonna stand, I think we could probably manage one more, maybe one more. I gotta get a different instrument, but this one's another one that's for my kids, and you might have heard it before. So again, if the refrain sounds familiar, sing along. That includes you, Luther and Isaac. If the refrain sounds familiar, and Liam, especially Liam. You have beautiful voices, so feel to contribute them. I love you guys.
Okay, I'm gonna look over your shoulder.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Christmas ring. Peace and joy, good tidings bring. Raise your voices and we'll sing. Hooray to Christmas Day. Oh, hooray for Christmas Day. Hear the bells of Christmas ring. Peace and joy, good tidings bring. Raise your voices and we'll sing. Hooray for Christmas Day. Oh, hooray for Christmas Day. The season loves upon us now. Scented candles, holly boughs. No time for cares, just do a vow. With Christmas coming now. Hear the bells of Christmas ring. Peace and joy, good tidings bring. Raise your voices and we'll sing. Hooray for Christmas Day. Oh, hooray for Christmas Day.
The snow is softly falling down. Birds for warmer times are bound. Kin and kin will soon be round to warm the winter's night.
Hear the bells of Christmas ring. Peace and joy, good tidings bring. Raise your voices and we'll sing. Hooray for Christmas Day.
Oh,
hooray for Christmas Day. What cares for wind or snow tonight? The whistle bowl will flow tonight. Sing the songs of long ago, so let the music play.
Hey,
hear the bells of Christmas ring. Peace and joy, good tidings bring. Raise your voices and we'll sing. Hooray for Christmas Day. Oh, hooray for Christmas Day. Christmas ring,
Christmas joy, good tidings bring.
Raise your voices and we'll sing. Hooray for Christmas Day.
Oh, hooray for Christmas Day.
Hear the bells of Christmas ring. Peace and joy, good tidings bring. Raise your voices and we'll sing. Hooray for Christmas Day. Hooray for Christmas Day.
Thank you for coming. Merry Christmas.